humans have long looked up at the sky, seen the birds, and dreamed that they too might be able to fly. Unsurprisingly, many have tried. Leonardo da Vinci, the Montgolfier brothers, who invented the hot air balloon, Orville and Wilbur Wright, my idiot cousin who, seeing his friend in the garden below, thought it was a good idea to shout, "Look at me! I can fly!" and promptly threw himself out of an upstairs window. In 1589, there was a suspiciously similar incident in Conwy, North Wales, when 7-year-old John Williams decided that if he threw himself off the walls of Conwy Castle, the wind would take him, and he would be able to fly over the sea to Skye. Nope. Didn't happen, did it? He just went onto the rocks below. He survived, but he wasn't having any children afterwards because, well, he managed to castrate himself. It shouldn't be funny, but for some reason, it is. Basically, what I'm trying to say is that men have been falling out of the sky since before recorded history, and the only people who've been happy about it are the Weather Girls and Jerry Halliwell.
It's a rain of men, hallelujah, it's a rain of men, amen, it's a rain of men, hallelujah, it's a rain of men.
Given man's long-held desire to fly, it's no surprise that mythology and legend all over the world is littered with stories of flight and failure. A case of fly me to my doom, you might say. The most famous in Western mythology is Icarus, son of Daedalus, and who flew too close to the sun, melting his wax wings and plunging into the sea. Arguably, that is one of the most famous and influential of all myths. It has even resulted in an estimated 15 people in the United States being called Icarus. I mean, yeah, okay, it's a decent name, so long as your family doesn't have a history of throwing themselves out of windows. Geoffrey of Monmouth, meanwhile, tells us of King Bludud, father of Lear, who Shakespeare wrote about. Bludud practiced necromancy, and he communed with the dead in order to build himself a flying suit. And then he threw himself off the Temple of Apollo in London, which is either under Westminster Abbey or under St. Paul's. And basically, you can guess what happened. 1,000 pieces, according to Geoffrey. 1,000. What I'm getting at with this is that people trying to fly and failing to fly is a common thing in world mythology. And maybe there is a strong chance that some of these are based on fact. Perhaps Bludud was a king or a tribal leader in pre-Roman Britain who threw himself from the roof of a temple in order to prove he was all-powerful and blessed by the gods. Bludud was probably the sound he made when he hit the ground. Which brings me to the middle ground. A person where one of the only two things we know about them is that they jumped off a building. And the only reason we know about this person is because of one other man who wrote about him about a century later. Allow me to present Elmer of Malmesbury, living in the 10th century. We know of his attempt to fly because of William of Malmesbury, who was writing around 1125. Given that they were at the same abbey, it's probable that William had heard stories of Elmer from other monks gossiping about him, telling the story of Elmer's failed flight. So there's a good chance that Elmer did exist, but since what we have is second-hand testimony, it's probably best to take some of the details with a pinch of salt. It's more of an anecdote, Elmer is introduced in the year 1066 when Halley's Comet appears in the sky. We can see this in the Bayeux Tapestry. Elmer, having seen it before, prophesies doom for the nation. As he's seen it before, that would suggest that at the time, maybe he was around 80. At least 80. An old man shouting at the sky.
We're all going to die.
This is what William has to say about the flight attempt. In his early youth, he had hazarded an attempt of singular temerity. He had, by some contrivance, fastened wings to his hands and feet, in order that, looking upon the fable as true, he might fly like Daedalus, the father of Icarus, and collecting the air on the summit of a tower of Malmesbury Abbey, he had flown for more than the distance of a furlong, or 200 metres, but agitated by the violence of the wind and the current of the air, as well as by the consciousness of his rash attempt, he fell and broke his legs, and was lame ever after. He used to relate, as the cause of his failure, his forgetting to provide himself a tail. But, since William of Malmesbury heard of this a century later, since evidently he lived to tell his story, it became quite the tale. Okay, we don't know how old Elmer was when he made this flight attempt, but the words early youth would suggest that maybe he was a novice, perhaps 10, 12, maybe about 14, maybe a little bit older. Old enough to craft himself some wings anyway. We don't know if he ever tried again either, probably not. I think William would have mentioned it if he did. But as he survived, this does actually make it one of the more successful attempts at human flight. In fact, let's go through this a second. Elmer broke his legs. The guy in Conwy castrated himself. Does that mean my idiot cousin made the most successful attempt at non-powered human flight in history? By jumping out? Probably not.